فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So no person can say to أنا أشعري في العقيدة and I'm still upon Imam Malik's عقيدة. He can't be on عقيدة Imam Malik. These are the كلام of Imam Malik رحمه الله تعالى. And one of the people who falsely said that the A'imma and their followers were all Ash'ariyya is none other than Subki. Subki is the only one who pushed this opinion. I wouldn't say he's the only one, but he's one of the early people who said this. And everyone took that from him. That's not the case. That's not the case. So Ibn Malik, if you see here he is, he's Aqeedah and his Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And Ya Tullab al Ilm, all students of knowledge. The people who are now in opposition to the Aqeedah to Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah are large in amount today, they are large. And the hamilat al-shalisa, the efforts that are being put towards Aqidat Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah is great and is big. And the lies that are being made against it are great. And the followers of Aqidat Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah are falsely being accused of that which they are not upon. So it's now more than ever, it's upon every student of knowledge أَيَتَنَبَّهُ بِهَذَا that they give attention to this issue. And they give consideration to it. And that they spread and they put every effort, أَيَبْذُلُوا مَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ every effort that you have, أَدَّبُوا عَنْ هَذِي الْعَقِيدَةِ that you defend this aqidah. You defend it. And you also debunk عَلَى أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُرْجِفِينَ these murjifin, those individuals who have deviated from the straight path, their arguments, whether it be through social media, if you see shubuhat being thrown, and you have the ability and the knowledge to respond to these false accusations. Using all of that means you have, use it. And defend this manhaj and this aqidah. Ja'far ibn Abdullah, he said, Kunna inda malikin. We were with Imam Malik, faja'ahu rajul, a man came to him. فقال يا أبا عبد الله الرحمن على العرش استوى الله is above his throne كيف استوى how did he go above his throne الإمام مالك رحمه الله he never the way he felt he hadn't ever felt before as a narration mentioned فنظر إلى الأرض he looked at the earth and he put his head down he took a twig and he started to write on the earth sticking until he started to sweat. Malik started to sweat. Then he lifted his head up. And then he threw the twig. وَقَالَ and then he said, الْكَيْفُ غَيْرُ مَعْقُولِ The how cannot logically be known. You can't use your mind so much so that you come to know Allah as a kafir, you can't. You know why you can't? Because there's nothing to compare to Allah. There's nothing you can compare Allah to. You can't. وَالِاسْتِوَاءُ مِنْهُ And the way Allah went above His throne is ambiguous. It's unknown to us. وَالْإِيمَانُ بِهِ وَاجِبٌ And believing it is obligatory. وَالسُّؤَالُ عَنُ bid'ah, Asking about it is innovation. And then Malik said, وَمَا أَرَاكَ إِلَّا مُبْتَدِعًا I don't see you except as an innovator. وَأُمِرَ بِهِ فَأُخْرِجَ And he commanded the man to be taken and to be dragged out of this gathering and to be taken somewhere else. Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen brought a fa'idah ajeeba here. Are you there, brothers? Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen brought a fa'idah, which is what? That Al-Imam Malik would keep this man out of the gathering. Pay attention to this. Are you there? No one can come and say, how did you do that? This is the house of Allah. Can you kick somebody out of the house of Allah? Allah said in the Quran, وَمَنْ أَضْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ يَذْكَرَ فِي هَسْمُ Who is more greater in sin than the individual who what? Prevented the people to remember Allah in his house, who's worse than that? Are you there, brothers? That ayah can't be applied for Imam Malik. The reason is because Imam Malik saw harm coming from this individual. and the problems that he would bring. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Look how harsh Imam Malik was. Was he not harsh? Was he not tough? He was. Get out of the street. Leave. Why? This man just asked, cave. How? Are you with me, brothers? By Allah, I ask you, what would the situation be on somebody who doesn't just say how? He actually places, he puts down and he places foundations of innovation in place. What would the situation be? He places usul bid'ah. What would the situation be? Would it be worse? Much worse, right? So he just came out there, Imam Malik. And Imam Malik told him, leave our gathering. Now you have to imagine, Imam Malik telling you to leave a gathering is great, it's big. So, the same thing or something like this had happened at the time of Ummah radiallahu anhu. In a man by the name of Sabih ibn Islam. Sabih ibn Iraqi. And Imam al-Darimi mentions this in his Sunnah, or in his Musnad, that Sabih sat down with a group of individuals and then he asked him about the ayah, وَالْدَارِيَاتِ ذَرْوَى. He said, what is وَالْدَارِيَاتِ ذَرْوَى? What does it mean? In other words, this man, what he was trying to do was, he was trying to go to the ayat which are mutashabih. He was going to the verses which are mutashabih. They are ambiguous. And this man was leaving off the verses which were clear-cut. He was leaving the ayat which were muhkam. He was sticking to ayat which were mutashabih. And he was leaving off the muhkam. So what happened? They informed Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, sent a letter to Imam, the great noble companion Umar radiallahu ta'ala, informing him of this individual and what he's doing. Al-Sahabi al-Jalib, Umar radiallahu anhu, said, bring him to me. They brought him to Umar radiallahu anhu. When they brought him to Umar, what did Umar do? فَضَرَبَهُ, he beat him. He beat him so much that he hit him on the head and blood started to gush from him and it rolled on his face. Brothers, man only asked about وَالْذَارِيَاتِ ذَرْوًا, but there was a sense of feeling that this individual was heading towards what? He was heading towards innovation. He was placing foundations. He beat him. When he beat him, the man said to Umar, if you want to kill me, then kill me a good death. What you're trying to do, you're trying to attain from this, to kill me, then kill the good thing. But if you don't want to kill me, and you want me to repent, I have repented and repentance. Meaning, Umar hit the place where Shaitan was sending revelation on him. Smashed it. No longer Shaitan talked to him. So what did the man do? Umar radiallahu anhu, he prevented a year from people to speak to him. No one's allowed to talk to him and no one's allowed to take anything from him. Yeah, another iqab. Illahi alim, you with me, brothers? This is how tough they were when it came to innovation. They didn't want nothing to be added to the deen. Or nothing taken away from the religion. Are you with me, brothers? Because if you add something to the religion, and you add something, and you add something, and you add something, and you add something, well, how many things have been added now? Let's say this generation goes, the next generation comes, they add things onto it. The next generation comes, they add something onto it. And then the next one, what's going to happen? It's going to be a totally different religion. Are you with me? The religion is going to be a whole new religion, something else. We won't really recognize this religion. It's a new religion. That's why we have to be tough and not let anything change. Wallahi, even the smallest thing, to keep the religion pure and clean. If everybody comes and takes a black paper, white paper, and they take a black pen and they do dot, and you do dot. As time goes on, this white paper will no longer be white. Will it be white? It will no longer be white. That's how innovation is when it comes to the affairs of the religion. Everybody's adding something to it, the whole religion is going to change. Umar didn't want that. This is how tough they were. They were tightening the door so no one could come in. Are you there? And that's what we should be doing in order to keep the purity of this religion. Now people will get angry because they don't want to keep it pure. They are in, some of them are due to their ignorance, their influence, or whatever it may be. They get upset when this happens. But don't accept that from them. Don't accept it. Also, Imam Malik, rahimahullah, he was very well known for his taqwa, piety. Shadidul wara. He was excessively pious. And he had wara. Wara means great noble of integrity and nobility. Especially Imam Malik when it came to matters of religion. He had high level of piety when he gave verdicts and fatwas. From the term that Imam Malik, that he used to say a lot, was the statement, La adri, I don't know. Imam Malik used to use that a lot. And this shows piety and fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That when Malik rahimahullah would be asked a question, he would resolve to say, La adri, he didn't know. Would never be shy. And there's a powerful statement that he said, Ibn Abdul Barr brings in his kitab al-Itiqa, and Ibn Asak in Tariq al-Dimashq, that he said, Junnatul Alim, the shield of the scholar, Jazakallah khair. Junnatul Alim, the shield of the scholar is La'adri, I don't know. Junnatul Alim, the shield of the scholar is La'adri. Meaning, what do you use the shield for? When you're trying to protect yourself from what? From somebody throwing arrows or spears at you, right? That's when you use a shield. The person uses la'adri as a shield when questions are thrown at him and is unable to answer them. He resorts to covering himself and protecting himself. Junnatul alim, the shield of the scholar is la adri, I don't know. Ida aghfalaha, if he forgets to pick up his shield, usibat maqatilu, arrows will be thrown at him and he will die from them. Sahih. The question that will be thrown at you, if you don't use la adri as an answer and you answer without no knowledge, what's going to happen to you? You're going to be killed. You're killing your religion. This is a powerful statement. And this is a shield, brothers. You need to equip yourself with this shield. If you're asked about a matter and you don't know, don't be embarrassed to say, La adri, I don't know. And today you see social media. Wallahi, you see people who talk on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook and answer and yu'alliq wa yuhaqqiq wa yufti wa yad, and he's retweeted. He has no knowledge of the deen. No knowledge of the deen. So the person should stay away from that. Walidalika, sometimes you even see, you get put in positions. For example, let's say you lived in Saudi Arabia for 10-15 years. 10-15 years you lived in Saudi Arabia. Your family come and visit you, and they ask you a Ummah question. Just because you lived in Saudi Arabia for 10-15 years, people think you know what you're talking about, right? So you get asked a question. What's the ruling in this particular issue if this happens? Okay? You feel embarrassed. For 15 years I've been here. And they're asking me a question and I say, La adri. No. No, I'm not going to say that. So he what? He, without any hesitation, he just gives an answer. He says, now, this is the answer to your question. Has no knowledge of it. This is the times that taqwa is shown. And wara. Are you with me, brothers? You have to remember, Imam Malik was like that. And Imam Malik was like that. Listen to this. Abdurrahman ibn Mahdi said, سَأَلَ رَجُلُ مَالِكٍ عَمْ مَسَأَلَ. A man went to Imam Malik and he asked him about a question. وَذَكَرَ أَنَّهُمْ أَرْسَلُوهُ. A man came to Imam Malik and he asked him about a mas'ala. And he said to Imam Malik that there are people who put these questions to him, that he gathered these questions from some people, and that he traveled 6 months for Imam Malik. 6 months I traveled for you. And Imam Malik said to him, فَأَخْبِرِي الَّذِي أَرْسَلَكَ. Tell those who have sent you, or the one who sent you, tell him, أَنِّي لَا أَعْلَمُ لِي بِهَا أَنِّي لَا عِلَّ لِي بِهَا. Tell them, أَنِّي لَا عِلَّ لِي بِهَا. I have no knowledge of all those questions that you have with you. Then the man said, وَمَنْ يَعْلَمُهَا. Who knows it if you don't know it? And Imam Malik didn't say, oh yeah, if I don't know it, no one knows it. He didn't say that. What did he say? الَّذِي عَلَّمَهُ اللَّهِ. The one who Allah educated and taught is the one who knows it. Powerful it is. And look how, يَا إِخْوَ أُضُرْ بِمَا أَجَابَهُ الْإِمَامِ. Look how the Imam and Imam Malik rahimahullah responded. He responded powerfully, right? And this, where did he get this from? The word لا أدري. Where did he take this from? He was implementing what he took from his teacher Abdullah ibn Hurmus. He died in the year 148. His teacher Abdullah ibn Hurmus said to him once, and Imam Malik is saying this, سمعت Abdullah ibn Yazid ibn Hurmus يقول. And Imam Malik said, I heard Abdullah ibn Yazid ibn Hurmus say, this is his teacher, ينبغي للعالم. He said, it is necessary, it is needed from a scholar, and you worry that he inherits his followers and his colleagues and those who sit under him, those who take knowledge from him. The statement of the entity, he inherits them this. He leaves this with them. حتى يكون ذلك أصلا في أيديه. Until it becomes something that it's the true, it's the original essence, and it is something that's always in their hands. يفزعون إليه, they run to it. فإذا سئل أحدهم عما لا يدري قال لا أدري. That he's always got it with him. Whenever he's thrown at a question is thrown at him and he doesn't know, he runs to لا أدري. Ibn Wahb, who's from the students of Imam Malik, he said, I can fill this whole rock, okay, with the times that Imam Malik said لا أدري. Also, what is transmitted from Imam Malik that he also said, like Muhammad ibn Sirin said, Imam Malik used to also say, إِنَّ هَذَا الْعِلْمَ دِينٌ. This religion, this knowledge is a religion. This knowledge is a religion. فَضُوُوا. Look at عَمَّنْ تَأْخُذُونَ دِينَهُ. Look at you, who you take your religion from. الرَّامَهُ الْمُزِيُّ mentions this in his kitab Al-Muhammad al-Fasil. Khatib al-Baghdadi in his kitab al-Kifaya. Also in his kitab Al-Faqih wal-Mutafaqih, he mentions it in there as well, Khatib al-Baghdadi. Ibn Abd al-Barr, kitab al-Intiqa. Al-Tabhid also mentions it in there as well, Ibn Abd al-Barr. Harawi mentions it in his kitab Dhabu al-Kalam. Ibn al-Jawzi mentions it in his Muqaddimah al-Mawdu'at. Wallahi, one of the most fascinating statements that Imam Malik said that touched me really was this statement. Malik said, مَا تَعَلَّمْتُ الْعِلْمَ. I never learned knowledge. I never studied the religion. I never saw knowledge. إلا لنفسي, except for myself. ما تعلمت العلم, I have never sought knowledge. إلا لنفسي, except for myself. وما تعلمت, and I never learned knowledge. ليحتاج الناس إلي, so the people can need me. I never sought knowledge, so the people can need me. And we know the statement of the poet, فلتقصدوا أربعة قبل ابتداء. Before you seek knowledge, intend the following. These are the four things that you intend before you seek knowledge. أَوَّلُهَا الْخُرُوجُ مِنْ ضَلَالِ. The first thing you're learning for the first thing. When you're seeking knowledge, you need to come with four intentions. Four intentions that you need to have in place. أَوَّلُهَا الْخُرُوجُ مِنْ ضَلَالِ. The first one is to take yourself out of the darkness. You're actually doing just this for yourself. You're seeking knowledge for yourself. أَوَّلُهَا الْخُرُوجُ مِنْ ضَلَالِ. والثاني نفخ خلقي للجلال. والثالث إحياء للعلوم والرابع العمل للمعلوم. The second one is what? والثاني نفع خلق الجلال. The second one is to benefit those who are around you. What you want to do is you want to benefit those who are around you. Once you learn it for yourself, you don't want to be stingy, keep it to yourself. You want to give the people this information, you want to let them know. And the third one is وَالثَالِثُ الْحِيَاءِ لِلْعُلُومِ. And the third one is to revive the knowledge, the sciences. Some uloom, they're going to die if the people don't learn them. So you're keeping it so it doesn't die. And last but not least, وَالرَّابِعُ الْعَمَلِ لِلْمَعْلُومِ. And the fourth one is to implement that knowledge. Implementation of that knowledge. الْعَمَلِ لِلْعِلْمِ. Action of that particular knowledge that you've sought. So Malik ibn Anas is clearly saying, rahimahullah, he is saying, ما تعلمت العلم, I have never ever gained knowledge إلا لنفسي, except for myself. وما تعلمت, and I never learnt it, so the people can be in need of me. Allahu Akbar. This is ikhlas. And that's why he reached being Imam Dar al-Hijrah. He learnt it for himself. And Imam Malik died when the year was 179. And Imam Malik, rahimahullah, this great Imam, this great faqih, this great muhaddith, he has students. Many students. From his students are Abdullah ibn Wahbi. Abdullah ibn Wahbi al-Misri. Abdullah ibn Wahbi al-Misri, who died in the year 197. He's from the what? The students of Imam Malik. AbdulRahman ibn al-Qasim, who died in the year 191. AbdulRahman ibn al-Qasim, who died in the year 191. Ashhab ibn Abdul Aziz. Ashhab ibn Abdul Aziz, who died in the year 204. And other than them, inshallah, which we're going to mention them when we speak about the stages that the Madhab al-Malikiyya went through, inshallah ta'ala, the books that are authored in the Madhab and the Mukhtasarat that are written in the Madhab al-Malikiyya. But let's talk about the most famous, the most well-known students of Imam Malik. The most well-known students of Imam Malik is Abdullah ibn Wahbi al-Misri. Abdullah ibn Wahbi al-Misri is from one of the most prominent students of Imam Malik. Also from the most prominent students of Imam Malik is AbdulRahman ibn al-Qasim al-Misri. AbdulRahman ibn al-Qasim al-Misri is from the most prominent students of who? Al-Imam Malik. Also, Ashhab ibn Abdul Aziz al-Misri. Ashhab ibn Abdul Aziz al-Misri. Also, Abdullah ibn Abdul Hakam al-Misri. And we didn't mention this one before. Abdullah ibn Abdul Hakam al-Misri is the first time I mentioned him. He died in 214 Hijriah. And last but not least, Ma'lu ibn Isa al-Madani. Ma'lu ibn Isa al-Madani. He died in the year 198. Ma'lu ibn Isa al-Madani. He died in the year 198. The student who was considered from the mulazimin of Imam Malik. He did mulazima of Imam Malik. A mulazama, which was mulazama tammah, complete mulazama, until he was called Usayyatu Malik. He used to be called Usayyatu Malik. What does that mean? The walking stick of Imam Malik. That's Imam mulazama shadida. He used to sleep. Mu'ayyan, I'm a ma'an, sorry. Ibn Isa al-Madani, he used to sleep in front of Imam Malik's house. He used to sleep in front of the door. كَانَ يَتَوَسَّدُ عَقَبَةَ الْبَابِ. In front of the door, he would tie, that was his bed. He never lived, he lived nowhere else. If Imam Malik came out, he would get up and he would go with him. And he would walk with him. He never, ever, as it was said, إِنَّهُ كَانَ لَا يَتْرُكُ شَيْئًا يَلْفَضُهُ Imam Malik. He would never, ever miss anything Imam Malik said. إِلَّا وَكَتَبُ لِسَتْهِ سُوَعَتِهِ. Anything Malik said, فَائِدَ, write it. Another one, فَائِدَ, wrote it. This was from what? مِنْ شِدَّةِ حِرْسِهِ عَلَى الْعِلْمِ. How he was so severe and how he was consistent and continuous in seeking knowledge. And you know, brothers, as Imam Shafi'i said, يَا أَخِي لَمْ تَلَانَ الْعِلْمَ إِلَّا بِسِتَّةِ سَوَبِيكَ عَلَى تَفْصِيلِهَا بِبَيَانِ. From them is what? Suhbah to stand. Befriending a teacher is from one of the six ways Imam Malik Shafi'i mentioned that a person can gain knowledge. Are you there, brothers and sisters? If you want to gain knowledge, you want to seek something, you want to learn it, you have to do mulazama. What do? Mulazama. Don't stop. If you do iqta' and you stop for a little bit or you daze your way, that's it. You're not going to learn it. That's how you have to be. That's how you have to be. Inshallah ta'ala, we're going to conclude here by Ibnillah al-Kareem. And inshallah ta'ala, next lesson, we'll be doing some matters pertaining to Madhab Imam Malik at the stages and the way that it went. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaybar, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.